All right, Dugout by the Backseat Lovers. I've been learning this for a little while now. I've been trying to figure out as much of it as I can, just by ear. And I think I've got most of the song down, so I can kind of share it with you now. I'm just going to do the main parts of the song. I'm not going to go way too far into the leads, but just what you need to get by. So it's going to start out on an A major chord. This is tune standard, and it's all open chords. And then right there, he goes from that A major chord down into an A major 7 chord. So together. And then it goes into the lead lick. And I'm going to put all the, I don't actually have real tabs for it, but I'll tab out the licks and the chords in the description just for the sake of simplicity, since it is kind of difficult to figure out exactly what I'm doing just by me talking. So it goes from that A into that A major 7 and then into the lead lick. That's a 5 on the A string. It's all sliding too, so slide into the 5 on the A string, slide into the 9 on the A string, slide into the 11 on the D string, down into the 9 on the D string, and then down to the 7 on the D string. Back to the 9 on the A, back down to the 5, back to the 9 on the A, and then the 11 and the 9 on the D. So together, 5, 9, D string, 11, 9, 7, 9 on the A, 5 on the A, 9 on the A, 11, 7 on the D. And that's pretty much the whole opening part. He just repeats that a couple times. You can also play the lead part, or the beginning part at least, with just open chords if you don't want to play the lead. If you're on acoustic or something, you can still sing over it with this variation. It's just not as close to the real song. It's just open chords. So it's going to be A, A major 7, D major, D minor. And that's just the chord structure, but rather than playing that, like, it's just finishing it with D and the D minor. So that would sound like this. And then he'd sing over that, obviously, and it's that same thing. Alright, so after the beginning of the song there, he moves into the part where he's just pretty much alternating between two chords, and it's the lyrics are, well, I don't want to, that part. What I found is the best to play that is just a D major bar chord and a D major 7 bar chord alternating between each other. It's not 100% right, I don't think, but it should fit pretty well. So, but I don't. That's just a 5th fret bar chord between the D major and the D major 7. And again, all these chords are going to be tabbed in the description if you don't already know them. Or you could just look them up. They're pretty basic chords. So then after that, there's this cool lead part that he plays. Sounds like this. Start on the 12th fret of the A string, then you're going to have your ring finger on the 14th fret of the D string, and then your middle finger 13th fret of the G string, and all you're doing is picking A, G, D. So A, G, D, A, G, D. In that order to get that sound. So again, 12 on the A, 14 on the D, 13 on the G. Then he's gonna move down to the 9th fret of the A, and he just plays a power chord. So 9th fret on the A, 11th fret on the G, or the D, sorry, and then another 11th fret on the G. So it's gonna be 9, 11, 11. That's the best I could figure out for that part. I know it sounds a little higher gain, maybe even up a few notes in the recording, but that seems to fit pretty well. After that part comes another little lick that he plays, this part. So he's always doing there. He's doing an A major bar chord off the 5th fret. The only thing that he's doing there, other than just picking, is he's lifting his index finger off the 5th fret to get an open E every couple notes. So, and then it would be the lead lick. Did the wheel lick at the beginning of the video, so I'm not going to do that again, but I will let you know that he finishes it off a little differently. So instead of doing it like he did at the beginning, which was like this, he just adds the 11th fret back in. So now it's going to be like this. At least that's what it sounds like to me. But you can mess around with that. It's pretty straightforward. All he's doing is really just adding a little bit of variation to the lick that we already did. All right, then the next part of the song, and these are the last two parts that I figured out. I think it should give you pretty much the entire song if you just put all these together in the order that they go in. It's just gonna be a lead into the bridge part. So it's power chords. So it's going to be a power chord on the 5th fret of the A string, power chord on the 2nd fret of the A string, and then a power chord on the 2nd fret of the E. Those are the only three he uses there. And then it goes back into that. All right, then the final part of the song after that is the distorted part, which I'm not actually going to distort, but it should sound like this in a clean tone. Play that, the first part's gonna be a 12 on the A string, it's gonna be a 13 on the G string, and then a 14 on the B string. So 12 A, 13 G, 14 B. Next chord's gonna be a barred 14th fret on the A string with a 16 on the G and a 15 on the B. So 14, 14, 16, 15. And then to get that little shift in there, all he's doing is picking up off the 16th fret. So it's all 14 with a 15 on the B. And he goes right back into that first chord. That'll be tab below as well. Then to finish up the song, just going back to that riff on the A major chord. And then that should fade out the song, and that's the whole thing. All right, thank you for watching. Comment any other songs you want me to attempt to learn, even though I know these tend to be a little bit choppy. Hopefully this helped you out, and I'll see you next time.